Breaking shots fired at Texas Christian University, two shooters identified, here's what's happening now. It's been a terrifying week for Texas and it's only Tuesday. Almost 48 hours after 26 were murdered in a Baptist church in Sutherland Springs, more Christians faced the fear of an attack after shots were fired in Fort Worth at Texas Christian University. Two shooters have been identified and now everyone at every campus, church location, and other places where religious groups gather have been issued an urgent warning. On Monday, we reported that a Christian academy in Fort Lauderdale, Florida had gone on lockdown after receiving a threat that campus officials alerted authorities to. Bullets were found on the property but a suspect was not identified, nor was a weapon recovered. Police lifted the lockdown order and classes and student pickup soon resumed to normal. Now, shots have actually been fired at another Christian campus, this time in Texas, who just suffered a Sunday church service massacre. The reason for it is sick. NBC DFW reports. A shuttle bus driver at Texas Christian University opened fire on another bus driver, prompting a campus-wide alert and lockdown Tuesday morning, police say. Fort Worth police said it began as an argument between two Roadrunner drivers in the 3600 block of West Canty Street at about 7 a.m. The suspected gunman shot at the other driver and missed, police said. The shooter hit the other driver while trying to drive the bus away from the scene, police said. Police found the shooter's bus off campus nearby. The driver was later arrested. No students were on either bus at the time of the shooting, TCU police say. The shooting prompted a campus-wide alert, which read, TCU alert, armed person on campus. Seek safe shelter immediately. More updates to follow as available. The lockdown was lifted after about 30 minutes. TCU tweeted that classes would resume after noon Tuesday. The Alice Carlson Applied Learning Center in the Fort Worth Independent School District was also placed on lockdown following the shooting, said Clint Bond, district spokesman. Both drivers are contracted by TCU for their shuttle services and not actually TCU employees. They are now under review for what we can only see as suffering clear anger issues and posing a threat to students and other citizens. The timing of this incident couldn't have been worse, with the state of Texas on edge as well as Christians around the country who have been warned are targets. In the last week, there have been three deadly attacks, and now this threat comes on the heels of that. It's not a coincidence that there's a killing spree across the country as one typical sparks others deranged lunatics to go down in infamy after. Eight people were killed in a Halloween terrorist attack in Manhattan, New York, followed by three more fatalities in a Colorado Walmart 48 hours later when a gunman casually walked in and began shooting people. 4 days after that shooting spree, an anti-Christian killer massacred 26 churchgoers in Texas. This is not a gun problem, it's a deranged individual problem of psychopaths seeking vengeance against a type of person they disagree with. For some reason, liberals seem to perpetually ignore this fact and blame the weapon, not the beliefs or affiliations of the person who pulled the trigger. Americans, specifically Christians, are under attack in these trying days prophesied about in the Bible that we are seeing come to fruition under the most terrifying terms. In September, white Tennessee churchgoers were ambushed and killed by a gunman in an unprovoked attack that was swiftly swept under the rug by the mainstream media, desperate to hide the important details and keep the attention on irrelevant issues like Russian collusion. Now, the blood of 26 faithful believers is now on their hands after disregarding the clear and present threat in this country to keep the focus on their rhetoric. There's no hiding what's happening now, and every American needs to be on high alert for what's coming. It took just a couple of hours for Barack Obama to come forward and condemn the weapon after the Sutherland Springs shooting. In the aftermath of the Islamic terrorist attack in Manhattan, the push to not blame the so-called religion of peace was immediate. Now there's little to no talk of what happened there, since the culprit was Islam and the left is fiercely protecting it. They didn't talk about blaming rented U-Haul trucks after the terrorist mowed people over, but now they can't stop talking about guns after a white male used one to murder 26 Christians. While this was a false alarm today in Fort Lauderdale, it could have also been a dry run or a failed attempt. Every incident like this needs to be looked at closely and taken seriously because it's dangerous to pass it off as an accident and ignore the issue. Had the potential targets in this case been an Islamic school or the dead victims in Sunday's shooting been at a mosque, the narrative from the mainstream media would be much different than what we're hearing today.